ओके स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट द फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन. व्हाट कैन कैन द मैक्सिमम व्हाट कैन द मैक्सिमम कॉपी डाउन द क्वेश्चन. मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ डिजिट्स be in the repeating block. Repeating block of digits in the decimal expansion of 1 divided by 17 दो decimal expansion ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು digits recurring ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ನೋಡಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆನಾ? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಡೂ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹೌ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಬೈ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 1/17. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರಿಪೀಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ ಲೈನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಒನ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. 17 outside because it is the denominator. This will become the divisor. Dividend will be 1. Okay na? So now you have a normal division tara madkondu hogbeku. Elli varigu madbeku andre nanage reminder alli vapas 1 barbeku. Illi 1 inda start martidinalla reminder alli 1 barbeku. Alli varigu nanu madkondu hogtane irbeku. Okay na? ಯಾವಾಗ ಒನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೋ ಅವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅದು ತಿರ್ಗಾ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಬಾರ್ ಬರೆದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಪೀಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಬರೀಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಈ ಒನ್ ರಿಮೈಂಡರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಬರೋವರೆಗೂ ನಾನು ಈ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಒಂದು 10 ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೂ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಪೀಟೇಟಿಂಗ್, ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿಕರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ ಬರೀಬಹುದು. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಸಿ, ಇಯರ್ 1 ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಇಯರ್ 17 ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. 1 ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ದನ್ 17, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಡೂ, ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಡ್ ಒನ್ ಜೀರೋ ಇಯರ್. 10, ಅಗೇನ್ 10 ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ದನ್ 17, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಡೂ, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ ಜೀರೋ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಡ್ ಒನ್ ಜೀರೋ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, so for 17 which is the closest multiple of 17 which is closest to 100, 17 ones are 17, 17 twos are 34, 17 threes are 51, 17 fours are 68. Okay, 17 fives are 85, 17 six are 102, so 102 is greater than 100, so I should go with 17 5s are, that is 85. Now what will be the remainder? 100 minus 15 if I do, I will get 15 as the remainder. 15 as the remainder. Okay, so 15 is smaller than 17. No, since decimal point is there, I can add 10 without any problem. Don't add 0 here students. If decimal point is there, 10 I can add easily. If I want one more 0, then I will put here 0. So 10 is enough. So 150 it will become. Okay, which is the closest multiple of 17 to 150? 17 9s will be 153, so it will be greater. So 17 8s is 136. So right, 17 8s is 136. So what will be the remainder? here 0 minus 65 do, it is not possible. Take one borrow from here, this will become 4, this will become 10. 10 minus 6 is what? 4. 4. Here 4 was 5, I have taken one borrow, so this will be 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. 1 minus 1 will be 0. So it is 14. 14 is the remainder, okay? So 14 is smaller than 17. So decimal point is there, 10 I can take easily. Okay? Again 17, 8 size only closest. That is 136. So what will be the remainder? Remainder will be 4. Okay? Okay students, 140 in the 136 na subtract madara, remainder will be 4. So 4 is smaller, so 10 I will add since decimal point is there. Which is the closest to 40? 17 2s are will be closest to 40. That is 17 2s are 34. So what will be the remainder? 60. Sorry, 6. 6 is the remainder. Since 6 is smaller than 17, since decimal point is there, I can add 10 here. So 17 how much is 60, which is the nearest to 60? 17 ones are 17, 17 twos are 17 twos are 34, 17 threes are is 51, 17 fours are is 68. So 17 threes are is closest. 17 threes are is 51. What will be the remainder? 9. Again 9 is smaller than 17. 10 I should add since decimal point is there. Closest to 90, which is the multiple 8s, that is 85. Remainder will be 5. So add 10, since decimal point is there, easily I can add 10. For 50, which will be the closest, 17 3s is 51, so I should take 17 2s. 17 2s will be 34. What will be the remainder? Remainder will be how much? 16. Okay, if I subtract 50 from 34, I will get 16. So 16 is smaller now. What I should do? Add 0. 160, which is the closest multiple of 17 to 160, 17 9 size is 153, 17 10 size is 170. So 17 9 size is 153. Okay, what will be the remainder? 7. Okay, so 7 is smaller than what? 7 is smaller than 17. No, so I should write 10. Okay, so for 70, which is the nearest multiple? For 70, nearest multiple will be 17 4s are, that is 68. 17 4s are will be 68. What will be the remainder? 2. So 0 I can add here. So for nearest multiple of 17 to 20 is 17 1s are, that will be 17 only. Okay. So what will be the remainder? Remainder will be 3. So 10 I can add since decimal point is there. For 30, which is the nearest? Again 1s. 17 2s will be 34. So I should go with 17 1s only. So it will become 1. Remainder will be 13. Okay, 30 minus 17 you will get 13 as the remainder. So 10 I can add since 13 is smaller than 17 and decimal point is there, 10 I can add. Okay, 17 how much size closest to 130? 17 7s will be 119. Oh, so I will take 17 7s 119. So what will be the remainder? Remainder will be 11. Okay, if I subtract these two numbers, I will get remainder as 11. Okay. So 10 I can add, which will be nearest to 110, 17 how much will be nearest to 110, 17, 6 will be 102, so this will be the nearest, so 80, so 8 will be the remainder. Since 8 is smaller than 7, I can add 10. So continuation, here only I will do, students, don't get confused. Here only continuation, so 80 is there here. So which will be the nearest number to 80? Nearest number to 80 will be what? Nearest number to, once again, nearest number to 80 will be how much? 17, 6. 17, 6 will be how much? 17, 6 will be 60. 17, 6 will be 68. So write down 68. Okay, 17, 6 will be 60. Sorry, 17, 4 is 68. Sorry, 17, 4 will be 68. If I subtract from 80, 68, I'll get 12 as the what remainder. Since 12 is smaller than 17, 10 I can add. So what will be the closest number to 120? It will be 17 sevens is what? 119. So remainder is 1. So we started with 1. Okay. We are ending with 1. Okay. So here I should stop and put one bar over this entire number. Okay. This entire number. If I continue again, what will come? I should take 10, since decimal point is there. Again, 10 is smaller number. I will write 0 here and take what? 100 here. If I continue, same numbers will get repeated. So after remainder 1 bandit takshna nevo, you should stop and put one bar. Okay, since I started with 1, I am getting back 1. So I should stop here and I should put bar here. So what you will write? Let us see. You will write. Sorry, wait, students, one second. So 1/17 will be equal to how much? Whatever you have got the answer, you have written now there. You can write that only. That is 0.058823524117647 whole bar. Okay, from this decimal point, 0 is there, no, from here to here whole bar. If I continue the division, this whole numbers will be repeating. It will be repeating. Okay, so this is the decimal expansion of 1/17. Okay, students, so let us go to the next question. That is sixth question. See, okay, let's go to the sixth question. Look at several examples of rational numbers in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers with no common factors other than 1. Having Terminating decimal representation. Can you guess the property of Q? Okay, copy down the question. I will explain how to do. Look at rational numbers in the form P by Q, where P and Q are integers with no common factors. Then 1 and having terminating decimal expansion. Terminating decimal expansion. Okay, can you guess the property of Q? Must satisfy. See students, what they are telling, you should give some examples of rational numbers in the form of P by Q, where P and Q should not have any other factors than 1. You know what is prime numbers, no? Prime numbers are numbers which are divisible by itself and divisible by 1. So, prime numbers, if I write in P by Q form, I will get, there will be some examples of the question which is asked. So, prime numbers will have only factor 1 and itself. So, if I write prime numbers in the form of P by Q, I will satisfy these examples. But one more point they are telling, that their decimal expansion, if I do, I should get as terminating decimal expansion. What is terminating decimal expansion? All of you know, no? What is terminating? If I do the decimal expansion, after some step, I should get 0. Okay? Then only it is called as terminating. Okay? So, solution. Some examples are solution. Some examples are 2 by 5. 2 by 5. See, 2 is a prime number, 5 is also a prime number. And if I do decimal expansion of 2 by 5, what I will get? Let me see. 2 inside, 5 outside. Okay. See, 2 and 5 both are also, they don't have any common factors other than 1. Okay, so if I continue, what I will get? See, 2 is smaller, so I'll take 0 point, so this will become 20. So 5 how much are 4 are 20. So I'll get 0. So this is terminating decimal expansion. So this is one example. Let me take 5 by 2. So if I do 5 by 2 expansion, what I will get? 5 inside, 2 outside. So 2 how much are 5 closest? 2 2s are. So 4. 2s are 4. 1 will be remaining. 1 is smaller. So what I should do? I put decimal point here. I can take 1 0 here. 2 5s are 10. So this will be equal to 0. So decimal expansion of 5 by 2 will be what? 2.5. See, let me take 3 and 3 by 5. 3 by 5 if I do, see 3 and 5 are having only one common factor, that is 1. 1 ones are, sorry, 3 ones are 3, 5 ones are 5. Okay? 1 into 3 if I do, I will get 3. 1 into 5 I will do, I will get 5. Other than 1, no common factor is there. So check decimal expansion. 3 inside, 5 outside. Since 3 is here, I should take point and I will write 1 0 since 3 is smaller than 5. So 5 how much are 30? 5 6 are 30. So write 30 as it is. So 0 I am getting as the denominator, sorry, as the remainder, sorry. As the remainder, I am getting 0 means this is terminating. If I take 3 as the denominator and 5 as the numerator, again they are not having any common number. Okay? So if I do like this, what I will, 5 inside, 3 outside. Closest to 5, 3 ones are, that is what? 3 ones are 3, 2 will be the remainder. So point I will take, I'll take what? 0, 1 0 here. So closest to 20, 3 threes are. Again, 2 is coming. Again, if I do, I will get 20. I'll take 3 threes are. Again, 18. So this will get repeated again and again and again. So for this, what will be the decimal expansion? 1.33, so on. See, these three are terminating. This is not terminating. Okay, this is not terminating. So see what is common in these three that is different here. See here, in all this 5 and 2 are there. Okay, so in denominator 5 is there, here 2 is there, here 5 is there. Here when other than 5 and 2, here it is 3. ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಕಡೆನೂ ಫೈ ಟೂ ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತ್ರೀ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಯೂ? ಇಫ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಆರ್ ಫೈ, if q is a factor of 2 or 5, then this condition is satisfied. Okay, if 2 is a factor of 2, okay, the condition is if the So, if Q is a factor of 2 and 5, then it can be factor of 2 and 5 or both, then this condition will this condition will satisfy. Okay, ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫೈವ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಟೂ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೋ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಫೈವ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಟೂ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಯಾವ ನಂಬರ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ತ್ರೀ ಬಂದಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದು ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯೂ? ಇಫ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಆರ್ ಫೈವ್ ಆರ್ ಬೋತ್, ಕ್ಯೂ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೈವ್ ಇದ್ದು, ಅಥವಾ ಇವೆರಡು ಟೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೈವ್ ಇದು ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದ್ರ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. We have finished the sixth question, correct? No? So let us go to the seventh question. Seventh question is, find three numbers whose decimal expansion are non-terminal and non-recurring. See students, what is non-terminating and non-recurring? ನೀವು ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಯಾನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಝೀರೋ ಬಂದರೆ, ರಿಮೈಂಡರ್ ಝೀರೋ ಬಂದರೆ ಅದು ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್. ನಿಮಗೆ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಯಾನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ರಿಮೈಂಡರಲ್ಲಿ ಝೀರೋ ಬರೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್. ನಿಮಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ನಂಬರು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಮೈಂಡರು ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಆದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಕರಿಂಗ್. ಆ ರಿಮೈಂಡರು ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ ಪಕ್ಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿಕರಿಂಗ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಡೂ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಟ್ ರಿಮೈಂಡರ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿಕರಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆನಾ? For that, examples of, three examples of non-terminating and non-recurring will be what? Let us see. 0.10, 1000, 10000, 10000, 1. Okay? So on. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಝೀರೋ ಒನ್, ಒನ್ ಝೀರೋ ಝೀರೋ ಝೀರೋ, ಝೀರೋ 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 ಝೀರೋ, ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಒನ್ ಝೀರೋ ಝೀರೋ ಝೀರೋ, ಫೋರ್ ಝೀರೋಸ್ ಇದೇ ಥರ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋದ್ರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಝೀರೋ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಝೀರೋ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ಝೀರೋ, ನಾಲ್ಕು ಝೀರೋ, ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಒನ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಐದು ಝೀರೋ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆರು ಝೀರೋ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಈ ಥರ ನಂಬರು ನೋಡಿ, ಇದು ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿಕರಿಂಗ್. One more example can you give? Example So one more example will be 0.2. Admele 1 0 tagoli. Amel 2 bariri 2 zeros tagoli. 2 bariri 3 zeros tagoli. Again 2 bariri 4 zeros tagoli. Again 2, so on. Okay. Idu innondu example. Okay na? Next example 0.310. ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ 2 0 ಬರೀರಿ, 3 ಬರೀರಿ, ತಿರ್ಗಾ 3 0 ಬರೀರಿ, ತಿರ್ಗಾ 3 ಬರೀರಿ, 4 0 ಬರೀರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ 3 ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ನಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿಕರಿಂಗ್. ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗಿವ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ 5100, 5100, 5100, 5100, ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ non-terminating and non-recurring. Okay.